Okay, good evening, Toastmasters, fellow friends and guests. So, my name is Kendrick, and today I'm going to be doing my Project 3. And as you can see in the slide, it's very obvious, the title is Procrastination. So, pardon me, I have a little bit of a sore throat, so, you know. I'll be fine. So, okay, let me just start, right? So, haven't we all had too many encounters with this guy?
Yes.
Procrastination. You know, isn't it all too familiar? So, actually, procrastination is like a drug. We all know it's bad. We all know it's bad for us. Nobody wants to procrastinate. But it just feels so good to procrastinate. Am I right?
Yeah.
Everybody? I'm pretty sure everybody in this room has procrastinated at least once in their life. Heck, even 10, 20, 100, 1,000 times. But no, my topic isn't procrastination. It's about how to overcome it. Alright? So, let me just give you a perfect example of procrastination. Okay, this slide. I just did this slide about a few hours back. I drafted up this speech about a few hours back. And yeah, I procrastinated, I admit. Okay, so if I didn't procrastinate, I may have done it days, weeks, you know, way long, way back, all right? And the worst part of procrastination is actually, you don't actually feel it after it really hits you. So I don't know if this has been a problem for you guys. But what happened back then, like for me all the time, just scrolling through some YouTube videos, always watching, like in the middle of the night, like maybe 12 a.m., saying, hey, it's okay, I can do another 1 hour of YouTube. And then the next thing I know is 3 a.m. in the morning. And I'm like, oh no, shit. You know, then the next day your plans is just all screwed up, right? Or maybe just playing video games, your favorite video game, and then you're just so close to achieving that objective. So you say, maybe just 1 more hour, just 1 more hour, just 1 more hour. And then it all builds up. So they all always feel very justifiable because it feels good. It's enjoyable. You like to do these things when you procrastinate, you like to read a book, anything, you know, anything but what is important. That's why they always feel justifiable, and it just until it really eats into your schedule. Alright? So comes the big question. How do I overcome procrastination? Alright, over here I wouldn't say I'm a perfect, you know. Guy, you know, I don't procrastinate and stuff. I still do procrastinate. But I feel like the answer is very simple. You don't overcome procrastination. You accept the fact that you are lazy sometimes. You accept the fact that you will definitely procrastinate, be it how disciplined you are. But always make sure that you have a plan B, a backup plan. Because sometimes when you procrastinate, we don't think like of the things that we might have to face later on, you know, lack of sleep, and then you don't study, you fail your exam. So you must always learn and by the hard way, right? What happens is something really terrible happens because of your procrastination. Then you learn. It's very negative reinforcement, but it works. So honestly, for me, you just really have to get a balance for procrastination. Just procrastinate, it's fine. Go ahead and procrastinate. But make sure you get a balance. Make sure you don't procrastinate too much, and you always have a backup plan. So you say, tonight I'm gonna watch Game of Thrones, like 5 episodes, or whatever, and then it's gonna be 5 a.m, and I gotta be at class for 8 a.m. tomorrow. Don't do that, just do 2 episodes. Sleep at 2 a.m, wake up at 5, or I mean, wake up at like 7 a.m, and then go to school. Make sure you go to school, and make sure you have a little bit of enough sleep. So, I wouldn't say I'm an expert, like I said, so I just want to throw it out and share with you guys my little trick, you know, which is the negative reinforcement. If you really feel like it's not working, you know, just really keep procrastinating until something really bad happens. Okay? Go and learn the lesson the hard way. I don't know, maybe if for your exam, you're supposed to study for your exams, maybe UOL students, supposed to study for your exams, but you're doing something else, maybe playing games, playing Fallout 4, watching, I don't know, Game of Thrones, or like, anything, you know, even reading a book or something, anything but studying, all right? Just go ahead and procrastinate, it doesn't matter. And just fail your exam once, remodule it. Feel the pinch, so expensive and everything's, oh shit. But actually it's very good. It's very good negative reinforcement because after that, you'll really, really learn that procrastination really is, you gotta pay a very, very hefty price for procrastination. So I just want to end off with a little quote, right, that I found online. procrastination is like a credit card. It's a lot of fun until the bill comes.
Wow.